Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be going over how to morph between a circle and a square in SketchUp without plugins. All right, so I saw this on the SketchUp forums. It was a tutorial that was put out by Box. He did a little GIF of it, so I figured I'd make it a video, but kudos to him, because I actually didn't understand or know that there were cardinal coordinates that were attached to your shape. So hopefully you guys get a tip out of this too. So I'm going to draw a circle here. So just C for circle, hit P to push pull this up. So now I have a cylinder. I'm going to hit R for the rectangle tool, and then draw my rectangle here. I guess it's more square-like. Now, the thing that I didn't know is that there are actually cardinal coordinates that are associated with this shape. So you see these little dotted lines. I can actually push or pull these arches that, well, what are now arches, to the square that I just drew. But you'll see if I try to do it here, it doesn't work. So you have to go to that cardinal coordinate. And when you draw your circle, you just want to make sure that when you're starting at the origin, let me move this off to the side really quick, that you're going in a cardinal direction. So don't go this way, because, let me just show you really quick, it becomes more problematic. I can't just easily draw that square that I had. This is like kind of working, but you can see it doesn't touch here. So it just becomes problematic. So the real key to this is just making sure that you're drawing in an actual direction, a cardinal direction, and makes that drawing that rectangle or square or whatever much easier. So yeah, hopefully this helped. Let me finish this really quick, and then there you go. Yeah, so hopefully this helped. Hopefully you guys learned something like I did. If you have any questions on this or anything else SketchUp related, don't forget to leave them in the comments below. If you liked this and it was helpful, please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.